Hey, what's up, guys? It's Ben from Seven Clean Seas here. I'm here talking to you today at the It's Time Festival hosted by Ecologi, and we're gonna talk about ocean plastic pollution. Seven Clean Seas is based in Singapore. I'm in Singapore right now, and imagine you guys are over in the UK, but this problem is a global problem, and we all wanna save this guy right here. So let's get stuck straight in. Let me just share my screen. So what is the plastic problem? I mean, everyone knows that we have a problem. Everyone knows that kind of our oceans are in crisis because of climate change, but what is the problem? Before we get stuck straight into it though, I'm actually going to tell you the story of three identical friends, three plastic bottles, but these three friends have very, very different stories to end up with. But what is plastic? So plastic is first born in an oil refinery by taking oil and gas and combining it together from monomers to form polymers. Now, if this is gonna work just here, boom, there we go. So that's monomers forming polymers, forming polymer chains. These polymer chains then end up forming pellets. Now, these are kind of plastic pellets. They're very, very small, and these can be made into plastic bottles. Or, in fact, any other products that you can kind of imagine. So, I mean, tables, chairs, cutlery, chopsticks, plates, cars, it's in cars, it's in t-shirts. Plastic is everywhere. But why is it everywhere? Because we can use it everywhere. It's a fantastic material. Almost, it's a super material. But the way we use it has just gotten out of hand. So these pellets can be molded into plastic water bottles. These plastic water bottles can be filled with your favorite drinks, water, Coke, Sprite, Fanta, whatever your favorite drink is. These are then consumed and then discarded. So you've got our stick man here. He's going to be following us all the way through the presentation, and he's just drinking his favorite drink, water. And then, what's he going to do with it once you finish with the plastic bottle? He's going to throw it away. So the story of bottle number one, friend number one. So this bottle ends up in the trash can. Perfect. General waste. Amazing. The black bin, the black dustbin bag, whatever, ends up in the bin. This then gets picked up on a Thursday morning, usually for me, by a dump truck. Now, where on earth does this dump truck go? This dump truck goes to, you guessed it, the dump, the landfill, goes straight to the landfill. So this plastic water bottle, friend number one, ends up in the landfill. So it ends up with a bunch of other plastic brethren, and along with most other stuff, let's be real. You've got sofa chair there, you've got a wardrobe, TV in the back, suitcase over there as well, tires. So it ends up with everything, it gets mashed in. And actually, this can mean that plastic takes so much longer. So 400 to 500 years to break down, and even longer depending on the landfill. When it rains, what happens is the rain comes through the landfill and it forms this kind of toxic material with the plastic as it breaks down. And this is represented by the green sludge here. And this is actually called leachate. So the chemicals released form a toxic leachate. Now this leaks into the environment, leaks into the ground, poisons the ground and kills the wildlife. Now this usually only happens with unmanaged landfills. However, it can happen with kind of a lot of managed landfills as well. But I mean, it's better than being in the ocean, right? However, you know, it's not the best place for it. Bottle number one, it's ended up in a bad place with a lot of other plastic and with most plastic. This is where most plastic goes, fingers crossed. But where does number two go? So number two, bottle number two, ends up in kind of the same place. Or does it end up in the same place? Some bottles are littered. So this is when they're just discarded. I'm sure you've seen litter around in the UK, around in kind of wherever you are, around in Europe, over in Asia. And I mean, it's a massive, massive problem. And this is down to you not littering into our environment, caring about the environment, making sure that bottle gets disposed of properly. So what happens if a very bad person ends up littering? So we got our stick man here, he's missed the bin. He's gone for a bin shot and he's missed the bin. He's just left it. He hasn't even picked it up. But this can be littered on beach or in rivers, so by a park. And then it rains And then all that plastic washes into the river. And the river goes from a stream to a river. And then the river ends up in the ocean. All rivers end up in the ocean. That was from Finding Nemo. All rivers end up in the ocean. So what happens to the plastic when it enters the river? It ends up in the ocean. And what happens when plastic is littered on the beach? It ends up in the ocean as the tide comes in and grabs it. So this is a massive problem, obviously. Why is it a massive problem? Now what? Why is it a problem? Why is it an issue? Doesn't just damage kind of marine life as a whole, it damages the whole ecosystem. We have a problem with plastic. We use too much. It's a fantastic material, but when it ends up in an environment like this, it's not good. Firstly, there's kind of two ways that plastic affects marine life. Firstly, it kind of directly affects it. So you might have seen on kind of the internet, the video of the turtle, our friend right here, with the straw getting pulled out of his nose. Horrible, horrible video. It did fantastic job of raising awareness surrounding straws. And now a lot of people don't use plastic straws. Absolutely fantastic. However, that is how it affects it. So you see seagulls with plastic bags on their heads. And even sometimes turtles mistake plastic bags for jellyfish because their eyesight isn't so great. So when this happens, when they ingest it, they think they're full. They can't digest that plastic bag. So they eat even more plastic, and the bright colors make it look like food that was in the ocean or could be in the ocean. So when this happens, they starve to death. And that causes collapses in ecosystems and collapses in kind of the chain and the normal way of life under the kind of the sea. The second is a lot more sinister. So this is where plastic, such as the plastic that you see in this cartoon, this breaks down into tiny, tiny little pieces. Plastic never really goes away. These tiny, tiny, little, tiny pieces are called microplastics. Now, microplastics can be consumed by smaller animals, such as fish. Then the fish is consumed by the seal, and then the seal is consumed by the whale. And this plastic stays within the fish, and it then goes to the seal and goes to the whale. This is called bioaccumulation. Bioaccumulation is where plastic enters the body of an organism and then stays within the food chain as it goes up. Now, unfortunately, what else eats fish? Humans. We eat fish. So when that fish accidentally eats plastic, because nobody actually wants to eat plastic, obviously. But when that fish actually eats plastic, and then we eat the fish, we consume plastic. WWF released the report saying that we consume 5 grams of plastic every single week. But that depends on your diet. So just be careful, be conscious of the plastic that you're using. And just remember that next time you use a plastic bag, this guy could be getting affected and it could be consumed by that guy. But it's not all doom and gloom, trust me. So story of number three. So the first two friends didn't end up in a great place, but the story of number three. Number three is a little bit more uplifting, but rarely, rarely happens because the systems that we have in place are broken. So number three gets collected by a dump truck. It's actually disposed of properly by our stick man. It ends up in the recycling bin, cleaned. It's a clean PET bottle, which can be recycled. So it ends up in the recycling truck. It goes to the recycling plant. Absolutely fantastic. What happens to it then? It goes through a series of stages where the bottle is broken down, crushed, flaked, washed, and then repurposed into another material. The example they have here is kind of plastic hands, which is fantastic. It's got plastic screws. It can be turned into anything again. It gives that bottle a second life, which is amazing. So looking at it a bit more in kind of real life, so that plastic there, that plastic bottle, so you've got a stick man disposing of it in the proper trash, the recycling trash, along with the other plastic, the same type of plastic. This plastic then goes to the recycling facility. It's then flaked, which is the image number two you can see here. That flake is then pelletized into those pellets that we have in the beginning. So you're just getting the same ingredients again. And then those pellets can be made into fibers, which make t-shirts. Not this one, but it can be made into t-shirts, recycled t-shirts. It can be made into recycled bottles. It depends on how good that recycling facility is. But the point with recycling is that once you have a product that you've made, you can then reuse that product over and over and over again, which stops us digging out more oil and more gas from the earth and keeping those resources in the planet, which is fantastic. But what's actually the big secret behind this? 2 billion people don't have waste management services. So that garbage truck that turns up outside my house in Singapore on a Thursday, it doesn't, 2 billion people don't have that service, which is mind-boggling. And then if they don't have that service, it gets into the environment. They're very, very unlucky in a situation where they don't have these services. So they've got nothing else to do with their trash. So it ends up in the environment. And this is where you get images like this. It's extremely sad, but it does happen. And this is why Seven Clean Seas exists. Seven Clean Seas is an ocean cleanup organization dedicated to cleaning up the world's oceans. But don't just take it from us, take it from our team.
Hai, kembali lagi bersama saya Jason dan tim Beach Cleanup. Hari ini di minggu ketiga kami mengadakan Beach Cleanup tepatnya di Desa Kawal yaitu Pantai Bopeng. Yang sangat disayangkan adalah banyaknya sampah di kiri kanan di sepanjang pantai ini, banyak sampah plastik. Yang menjadi permasalahan adalah plastik sangat gampang didapatkan, juga harganya sangat murah. Tetapi tingkat kesadaran masyarakat itu sangat rendah karena masih menjadikan laut sebagai wadah tempat sampah. Jadi di sini saya menghimbau, mari kita lebih pintar lagi, lebih bijak lagi menggunakan plastik. Hindari penggunaan plastik sekali pakai. Less plastic please. Thank you.
Saya Panji dari The Island Foundation. Hari ini kembali, sudah ketiga kalinya saya mengikuti kegiatan dengan Seven Clean Seas. Sungguh sebenarnya saya sangat miris karena dari hari pertama kami hampir mengumpulkan 1 ton, hari kedua 1 ton lebih, dan hari ini sepertinya kami juga melebihi dari 1 ton. Satu hal yang sangat saya prihatinkan di alam yang indah ini, kita begitu mudah menemukan sampah-sampah plastik. Kepada para pemuda-pemudi di Bintan, mari kita kurangi sampah plastik dan cintai alam kita dengan lebih baik lagi. Salam dari The Island Foundation dan terima kasih untuk Seven Clean Seas dan juga PT Nikoi dan Cempeda. Terima kasih.
Awesome. So that was a sneak preview of our team over in Indonesia. Seven Clean Seas, as I said, is an ocean cleanup organization dedicated to removing 10 million kilos of plastic by 2025. We're also looking to be operating in the 7 worst plastic polluting countries in the world. So far, we're in Indonesia, which with our team that you just saw there, and we're also operational in Malaysia, and we're even entering into Vietnam now. So we're so close to actually kind of building up our capabilities to be operational in the 7 worst plastic polluting countries by 2025. These are some big goals because so far we've only recovered 73,000 kilos of plastic. We're super, super proud of this. That right there is from one of our beach cleans that we did in Singapore earlier this year, pre-COVID, when we could have events. We've recovered this amount of plastic, but we're looking to recover so, so, so much more because that is where we're going to have the impact. What can you do about it, though? We're removing plastic from the ocean, but what can you do to reduce your plastic consumption? And how does it go? So the zero waste pyramid relies firstly on to regulate the disposal. I said earlier that 2 billion people don't have waste management. So if we can get those 2 billion people and have them having regular safe waste management with kind of the governments, working with corporates and working with us to implement these waste management systems where they don't necessarily have them, that's where we're going to stop seeing leakage. Secondly, recycling, implementing more recycling plants throughout the world and getting the waste that we collect from these people and from kind of your household and my household, and then getting it to the recycling center and putting it back into the circular system so we don't have to use these raw virgin resources. Thirdly, we can reuse. Reusing something means that you're giving it a second life as well. It's kind of like recycling, but you don't have to process it. So if you do happen to use a plastic water bottle, how many uses can you actually get out of that? Can you reuse that plastic tub that you got from a takeaway? Can you put more stuff inside of it? Just have a think about ways that you can reuse and retain the value, retain the function of that product. Fourthly, this one's difficult because it requires a lot of system change. And you re-engineer products so that they're sustainable. They're made from sustainable products and they can be reused and taken back. Then you have kind of the encouraging of cyclical use of resources. So you stop the waste, you maximize efficiency, and you stop the wastage into the environment and through these processes. And finally, the best thing you can do is reduce and conserve material. This means kind of design out waste, provide a circular economy. So a circular system where everything used is goes into something else. So you're giving it a continued life. And this is how we're gonna achieve firstly clean oceans. We're gonna stop plastic pollution and we're gonna reduce waste into the environment. And it's gonna benefit the marine system massively. We just have these seven steps to follow. But what can you do? A call to action. So you can watch films, you can educate yourself. A couple of my favorites are here. Plastic Ocean, an amazing film to bring to light the kind of problem with plastic pollution. You can start your own. Get out there, get out on the beach, get to your nearest park, get to your nearest natural environment. Go get stuck in, go pick up some trash and make sure you dispose of it properly, because that's how communities start. Take your family down, take your friends down. You start to build a community, and that's how Seven Clean Seas started. It starts with an idea, it starts with a movement. You can eliminate straws, a very small but simple act. Use reusables. Have you got a tub that you can use over and over again for takeaways? Pack lunch boxes. Are you still using single-use packaging? Just have a think about what you're doing to help protect the oceans. And of course, you can ask for less plastic, please. Say no to the straw. Say no to a plastic bag. Do you really need it? Can you carry it? Think about the turtles. You can join our cleanup. Seven Clean Seas is expanding rapidly and expanding fast. So hopefully we'll be in kind of a beach. We'll be in a beach near you soon, over in the UK, over in China, wherever you are. But have a think about what else you can do. If you can think of any other initiatives, drop us a message on Instagram, say it, and we might even feature you on our stories. So thank you so much for listening to me today. If you've made it this far and you're still in the kids' tent, you're still engaged, well done. I know it was a doom and gloom presentation, but I've tried to keep it uplifting. It's a massive problem, but we will tackle it. We're at the bottom of a massive, massive mountain, but every single step, every single supporter, every single action you do gets us closer to achieving our goals. Let's get to work. I've been Ben from Seven Clean Seas, and I am over and out.